Good evening, friends. A gentle reminder that we will have the Bible study led by Brother Johnson Sequeira from 5:30 onwards on the same link. Please do remain joined. Let us keep the holy water by our side so that we can bless ourselves soon after the deliverance prayer. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Prayer for Deliverance by Pope Leo XIII. In the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and God, strengthened by the intercession of the Immaculate Virgin Mary, Mother of God, of Blessed Michael the Archangel, of the Blessed Apostles Peter and Paul, and all the saints, and powerful in the holy authority of our ministry, we confidently undertake to repulse the attacks and deceits of the devil. God arises, his enemies are scattered, and those who hate him flee before him. As smoke is driven away, so are they driven. As wax melts before the fire, so the wicked perish at the presence of God. Behold the cross of the Lord. Flee bands of enemies. He has conquered the lion of the tribe of Judah, the offspring of David. May your mercy, Lord, descend upon us, as great as our hope in you. Let us pray. We will make the sign of the cross on ourselves wherever we see the sign of the cross on our screens. We drive you from us, whoever you may be, every unclean spirit, all satanic powers, all infernal invaders, all wicked legions, assemblies, and sects, in the name and by the power of our Lord Jesus Christ. May you be snatched away and driven from the church of God and from the souls made to the image and likeness of God and redeemed by the precious blood of the divine Lamb. Most cunning serpent, you shall no more dare to deceive the human race, persecute the church, torment God's elect, and sift them as wheat. The Most High God commands you. He with whom, in your great insolence, you still claim to be equal, he who wants all men to be saved and to come to the knowledge of the truth. God the Father commands you. God the Son commands you. God the Holy Spirit commands you. Christ, God's Word made flesh, commands you. He who to save our race, outdone through your envy, humbled himself, becoming obedient even unto death. He who has built his church on the firm rock, and declared that the gates of hell shall not prevail against her, because he will dwell with her all days, even to the end of the world. The sacred sign of the cross commands you, as does also the power of the mysteries of the Christian faith. The glorious Mother of God, the Virgin Mary, commands you. She who by her humility and from the first moment of her immaculate conception crushed your proud head, the faith of the holy apostles Peter and Paul and of the other apostles commands you. The blood of the martyrs and the pious intercession of all the saints commands you. Thus, cursed dragon and you diabolical legions, we adjure you by the living God, by the true God, by the holy God, by the God who so loved the world that he gave up his only Son, that every soul believing in him might not perish, but have life everlasting. Stop deceiving human creatures and pouring out to them the poison of eternal damnation. Stop harming the church and hindering her liberty. Be gone, Satan, inventor and master of all deceit, enemy of man's salvation. Give place to Christ, in whom you have found none of your works. Give place to the one holy Catholic and apostolic church, acquired by Christ at the price of his blood. Stoop beneath the all-powerful hand of God. Tremble and flee when we invoke the holy and awesome name of Jesus. This name which causes hell to tremble. This name to which the virtues, powers, and dominations of heaven are humbly submissive. This name which the cherubim and seraphim praise unceasingly, repeating, "Holy, holy, holy is the Lord, the God of armies." O Lord, hear our prayer, and let our cry come unto you. May the Lord be with you and with your spirit. Let us pray. God of heaven, God of earth, God of angels, God of archangels, God of patriarchs, God of prophets, God of apostles, God of martyrs, God of confessors, God of virgins, God who has power to give life after death and rest after work, because there is no other God than you, and there can be no other, for you are the creator of all things, visible and invisible, of whose reign there shall be no end. We humbly prostrate ourselves before your glorious majesty, and we beseech you to deliver us by your power from all the tyranny of the infernal spirits, from their snares, their lies, and their furious wickedness. Deign, O Lord, to grant us your powerful protection and to keep us safe and sound. We beseech you through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. From the snares of the devil, deliver us, O Lord, that your church may serve you in peace and liberty. We beseech you to hear us. That you may crush down all enemies of your church, we beseech you to hear us. Amen. Let us bless ourselves with the holy water. Prayer. Saint Michael the Archangel, defend us in the day of battle. Be our safeguard against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly host, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who roam throughout the world seeking the ruin of souls. Amen. Mary, Queen of all saints, pray for us. Prayer to Saint Joseph. Hail, guardian of the Redeemer, spouse of the Blessed Virgin Mary. To you, God entrusted his only Son. In you, Mary placed her trust. With you, Christ became man. Blessed Joseph, to us too, show yourself a father and guide us in the path of life. Obtain for us grace, mercy, and courage, and defend us from every evil. Amen.
Good evening, brothers and sisters. Today we focus on the gift of being contented in our lives. As a society, we hunger and thirst for more and more worldly things in our lives. And when we do get what we crave for, it starts all over again. I'm reminded of that ad of Pepsi, which became famous in the early 2000s. Some of us may remember, Ye dil mange more. This heart craves for more. And it may be the latest gadget or a larger and more powerful car or more bigger house, or it may be travel. If it was Malaysia this year, next year it's got to be Thailand or some good place. And we tell ourselves, I'll be happy when I get that promotion or a new job or a bigger car and so on. And this craving is often driven by several things, either a desire for comfort, social pressure, or sometimes it's just emptiness inside and boredom. And the clue to being content is not in pursuing material things or achievements, but ultimately in pursuing God. And we know how Jesus has called us to be detached from the things of the world and to seek God's kingdom first. And he's promised that everything else according to his will shall be granted unto us. Dear friends, let us today pray for the gift of being content with what God has given us today, to shed the constant craving for the things of the world, and instead to seek the Lord as the first priority in our lives. Let us be an example to the world that true contentment and joy does not come from possessing things of the world, but rather it comes from knowing God and walking with him. Let us pray and repeat this verse 7 times. Those who seek the Lord shall not lack any good thing. Psalm 34:10. Amen. Psalm 34:10 says, those who seek the Lord shall not lack any good thing. Amen. Psalm 34:10 says, those who seek the Lord shall not lack any good thing. Amen. Psalm 34:10, those who seek the Lord shall not lack any good thing. Amen. Psalm 34:10 says, those who seek the Lord shall not lack any good thing. Amen. Psalm 34:10, those who seek the Lord shall not lack any good thing. Amen. Psalm 34:10, those who seek the Lord shall not lack any good thing. Amen. Friends, today we have a special mass offered for all our intentions by Father Ausse Pachan Nedumparambil. Let us pray specially for Father that God blesses him with a life of holiness and to be on fire, to be faithful to the Lord's calling, to spread the good news and God's love among thousands of people as the Lord leads him. And today's rosary is led by a wonderful family, John, Asha, and their family and their children, Sarah, Tracy, Kathy, and little Joseph. Let us pray for them also in our prayers as we begin the rosary. Let's begin. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
I believe in God, Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Do not bring us to the test, but deliver us from evil.
Holy Mary, daughter of the Eternal Father, strengthen our faith. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Holy Mary, Mother of the Beloved Son, increase our hope. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Holy Mary, radiant temple of the Holy Spirit, deepen our love. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
Let's meditate on the first glorious mystery, the resurrection. During this mystery, we pray specially for marriages and the gift of being content in our marriage. Now, we see couples focusing on several things, sometimes focusing on their career, accumulating wealth and new possessions, or travel to exotic places, enjoying themselves, and so on. Now, are these sinful or bad? No, not necessarily. It, however, assumes significance when these desires or these pursuits, they block or hinder God's plan for their marriage. I'm sure many of us know couples who postpone having a baby for reasons of career. You know, it'll be a hindrance for them. It'll be a disturbance for them enjoying their life or, you know, accumulating wealth or furthering their career. So they postpone starting a family for several years. And then guess what? It's almost too late, and then they struggle. And we also have cases of couples who pursue their careers and interests and neglect building their marriage, giving time for each other, loving each other, and so on. Quite often in our marriages, we can be discontented with each other, maybe in small ways or bigger ways. And this lack of contentment breeds resentment, leads to blame and bitterness and a broken spirit. And all this happens when we tend to forget the third person in our marriage, that is the Lord himself, who had brought us together in the first place and who keeps us together. We forget that all things begin with him, and our relationship with him needs to be strong at first. During this decade, we specially pray for couples that each spouse seeks to grow deeper in relationship with the Lord and together worship the Lord and discern his plan for their marriage. and keep that as the priority for their marriage. Let us pray for this intention during this mystery.
Our Father who art in heaven, holy be your name, your kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Do not bring us to the test, but deliver us from evil.
Hail Mary, full of grace, Lord is with you. Blessed are you, women, and blessed the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, Lord is with you. Blessed are you, woman, and blessed the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, Lord is with you. Blessed are you, woman, and blessed the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, Lord is with you. Blessed are you, woman, and blessed the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, Lord is with you. Blessed are you, woman, and blessed the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, Lord is with you. Blessed are you, woman, blessed the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, Lord is with you. Blessed are you, woman, blessed the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, Lord is with you. Blessed are you, woman, blessed the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, Lord is with you. Blessed are you, woman, blessed the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, Lord is with you. Blessed are you, woman, blessed the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
With the Father and Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, the world without end. Amen. O my Jesus, forgive us our sins, save us in the fires of hell. Lead all souls to heaven, especially those who are most in need of your mercy.
Mary, Queen of the Most Holy Rosary,
pray for us.
The second glorious mystery, the Ascension of our Lord Jesus. During this decade, especially pray for families, and that the families all over the world get the joy and the peace of being contented with what they have. It does not matter where we are in the scale of worldly possessions, but the reality is that almost all of us, we constantly seek out the better things of the world, better homes or gadgets or cars and so on. I remember reading the story of an American named Jack Whittaker, who in 2002 won the biggest lottery prize of around $300 million, a huge amount. And he was already fairly well off and having a peaceful life when he hit this jackpot. And I believe he had made a chance purchase of this lottery ticket, and you know, just on a fluke, he got it. But after winning, he even made a good start. He donated 10% of the earnings to Christian charities and also to several churches. And I believe one of these churches actually rebuilt their church after there was a hurricane that had hit their area. And he also helped a lot of poor families. But over time, he lost his way, and his life was replete with tragedies and also going on the wrong side of the law. At least three people connected with his family, his daughter, his granddaughter, and another person, they committed suicide, you know, associated with the drugs and other issues. And, you know, he was a target for thieves, and he had to, you know, lots of times thieves broke into his property, into his car, and stole money on several occasions. He died in the year 2020 after a long illness. But before that, he made a statement: winning the lottery was a curse for me. And our Lord in Luke chapter 12 says, "Watch out, be on your guard against all kinds of greed. Life does not consist in an abundance of possessions." And I'm sure all of us have accepted Christ as Savior and Lord, and we do possess a certain amount of peace and a real willingness to commit to serve the Lord. But on the other hand, often there is a tendency to fall back in the old routine of desiring and getting more things for us, more and more of the wealth and the goodies of the world. And we tend to rationalize that we may be somehow serving the Lord. Now, whether we get what we desire or not, sometimes there is a lack of peace, and there's possibly a lack of a slackening of the spiritual growth when we tend to follow the ways of the world. Recently in our family, we've been seriously contemplating a decision to make a purchase, a big purchase, and something that all in our family longed for. And we explored and found a few good alternatives, each with obviously its positive and negative points. So like good Christians, we offered it to the Lord as his decision. And after some contemplation, we understood that what the Lord was trying to tell us. And that led us to rephrase the question. So instead of asking us, "Lord, which should we select?" it was, "Lord, do you want us to make this purchase now or later on?" And then again, the Lord showed us that we had not asked the fundamental question, "Do you approve of this purchase first of all? Do you want us to make this purchase at all?" And this is a struggle which I think we all must make as families, to constantly seek the Lord as a family, to grow close to him and to hold his will dear in our hearts, to know his plan and to seek to follow it with all our hearts. And together in faith, let's thank the Lord, as in Philippians chapter 4, that as families, we today have learned the secrets of being content in whatever we have, whether in plenty or in scarcity. And we offer this intention as we pray this decade.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Do not bring us to the test, but deliver us from evil.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. O my Jesus, forgive us our sins, save us from the fires of hell, and lead all souls to heaven, especially those who are most near your mercy.
Mary, Queen of the Most Holy Rosary,
pray for us.
third glorious mystery, the descent of the Holy Spirit. In this decade, let's especially pray for our children that they get the grace to be contented with whatever that they have on a day-to-day basis. If you look at our society, our families have grown smaller. Families with more than two or three children are rare. And societal values have also changed. And today, parents are more and more indulgent towards children with more money available. And parents seek to please their children with more and more. And as they enter their teens, children expect to own gadgets. And I'm sure lots of us have heard, I'm the only one in my class without a smartphone or a laptop or a good bike and so on. And likewise, the expectation is that birthday parties tend to be lavish celebrations and so on. Now, on one hand, children learn from us parents. If we are not rooted in the Lord and we run after worldly possessions, we cannot expect them to be much different. And having said that, it is also important how we manage the numerous wants of our children and lead them to grow into mature Christians. We read of the example of the billionaire Ross Perot, who founded EDS and Perot Systems. Apparently, he ensured that his son would spend each of these summer vacations doing manual work to earn his pocket money. And we can learn from such examples, whether it's Christians or not otherwise, how wise parents get their children to actually do things which are probably a lot more harder for them, but help them to learn and get more involved, let's say, in helping others in small ways. For example, helping the sick and the lesser privileged members of society. And also be more aware of the blessing that they have and create thankfulness in their hearts. And in faith, let us all believe that the Lord has already given us spiritual wisdom so that we can follow Proverbs 22:6, where we train our children in the way that they should go, so that even when they're old, they will not depart from it. We also agree in faith that our children have learned the ability to be content in any situation through Christ. Let us offer this decade for this intention.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Do not bring us to the test, but deliver us from evil.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
O my Jesus, forgive us our sins, save us from the fires of hell, and lead all souls to heaven, especially those who are in most need of your mercy.
Mary, Queen of the Most Holy Rosary,
pray for us.
The fourth glorious mystery, the Assumption of Mother Mary. In this decade, let's offer intentions of all the church and vocations, all priests and nuns and religious all over the world, and especially for more vocations to come from our youth. We also pray specially for Jerome Barnabas, Nikita Maria, and Teresa Mary Abraham. In faith, we believe that the Lord has blessed them with the grace to be holy like our Heavenly Father is, and to serve the Lord with an undivided heart. If you look at our church today, and if you think about the world of today, which is so focused on accumulating possessions and enjoying life, we sometimes wonder how our priests and religious can be any different. And sadly, we do see examples of priests and nuns who have fallen prey to money and attractions of the worldly life. However, there are so many beautiful examples of priests and nuns who carry on their humble duties and often hard, backbreaking work with so much joy and serene contentment. Of course, Mother Teresa is an often quoted example, which you all heard so much about. But there are so many hidden people which we don't know about. And sometimes it's a joy. You know, we travel to some remote place and you come to a remote church and we find a parish priest there. You know, it's very happy and very peacefully serving a small flock very diligently. And you're not at all interested with the power and the glory of serving in a big city or a prominent church. You know, very comfortable and very happy there. There's so many such priests, so many hidden gems are there. Recently, we had the opportunity to visit a center for mentally challenged children in North Bangalore. Now, there were close to around 40 children of different age groups. And, you know, it's quite a burdensome task to look after them. They were just two nuns. They were heavily overworked. But when you talk to them, you know, you can sense that the burden is light on their shoulders. And, you know, the joy that they have of serving God's, you know, especially grace children was really coming out very strongly. And today, let's pray that the church all over the world is able to turn away from the world and not to be conformed to the world, to shun the attractions of the world, to be content with little possessions, and to work diligently for God's kingdom. Let's offer this intention as we pray this decade.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Do not bring us to the test, but deliver us from evil.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. O my Jesus, forgive us our sins, save us from the fires of hell, and lead all souls to heaven, especially those who are in most need of your mercy.
Mary, Queen of the Most Holy Rosary,
pray for us.
The fifth glorious mystery, the coronation of Mother Mary. We pray for all the intentions of the missionaries of prayer and this initiative, and also for all of us gathered together and for our families. We pray especially that all of us turn to God, not just for the problems that we have, the challenges that we have, but we diligently seek the kingdom of God in our lives, personally and for our families as a whole. And we make God the priority in our lives. We make God's plan and God's kingdom the priority in our lives. And as we do this, we fully believe that God will add all that we need in our lives. And in faith, that let me offer this prayer and this intention for this decade.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Do not bring us to the test, but deliver us from evil.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. O my Jesus, forgive us our sins, save us from the fires of hell, and lead all souls to heaven, especially those who are most in need of your mercy.
Queen of the Most Holy Rosary,
pray for us.
Spiritual Communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the Most Holy Sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Closing prayer. Sweet Mother Mary, I offer thee this spiritual communion to bind our bouquets in a wreath to place upon thy brow. O my Mother, I come to you today with all the prayers and intentions of every brother and sister who pray this most holy rosary today and lift their burdens along with mine to thee. Holy Mother of God, you have never turned away your children who have sought your help and intercession. Look with favor upon our gifts, and in thy great love, obtain for us these graces. Amen.
Litany of the Blessed Virgin Mary. Lord, have mercy on us.
Lord, have mercy on us.
Christ, have mercy on us.
Christ, have mercy on us.
Lord, have mercy on us.
Lord, have mercy on us.
Christ, hear us.
Christ, graciously hear us.
God, the Father of heaven,
have mercy on us.
God, the Son, Redeemer of the world,
have mercy on us.
God, the Holy Spirit,
have mercy on us.
Holy Trinity, one God,
have mercy on us.
Holy Mary,
pray for us.
Holy Mother of God,
pray for us.
Holy Virgin of Virgins,
pray for us.
Mother of Christ,
pray for us.
Mother of Divine Grace,
pray for us.
Mother most pure,
pray for us.
Mother most chaste,
pray for us.
Mother inviolate,
pray for us.
Mother undefiled,
pray for us.
Mother most amiable,
pray for us.
Mother most admirable,
pray for us.
Mother of good counsel,
pray for us.
Mother of our Creator,
pray for us.
Mother of our Savior,
pray for us.
Mother of mercy,
pray for us.
Mother of hope,
pray for us.
Virgin most prudent,
pray for us.
Virgin most venerable,
pray for us.
Virgin most renowned,
pray for us.
Virgin most powerful,
pray for us.
Virgin most merciful,
pray for us.
Virgin most faithful,
pray for us.
Mirror of justice,
pray for us.
Seat of wisdom,
pray for us.
Cause of our joy,
pray for us.
Spiritual vessel,
pray for us.
Vessel of honor,
pray for us.
Singular vessel of devotion,
pray for us.
Mystical rose,
pray for us.
Tower of David,
pray for us.
Tower of ivory,
pray for us.
House of gold,
pray for us.
Ark of the Covenant,
pray for us.
Gate of Heaven,
pray for us.
Morning Star,
pray for us.
Health of the sick,
pray for us.
Refuge of sinners,
pray for us.
Comforter of the afflicted,
pray for us.
Comfort of migrants,
pray for us.
Help of Christians,
pray for us.
Queen of Angels,
pray for us.
Queen of Patriarchs,
pray for us.
Queen of Prophets,
pray for us.
Queen of Apostles,
pray for us.
Queen of Martyrs,
pray for us.
Queen of Confessors,
pray for us.
Queen of Virgins,
pray for us.
Queen of All Saints,
pray for us.
Queen conceived without original sin,
pray for us.
Queen assumed into heaven,
pray for us.
Queen of the Most Holy Rosary,
pray for us.
Queen of Peace,
pray for us.
Lamp of God who takes away the sins of the world,
spare us, O Lord.
Lamp of God who takes away the sins of the world,
graciously hear us, O Lord.
Lamp of God who takes away the sins of the world,
have mercy on us, O Lord.
Pray for us, O Holy Mother of God,
that we may be made worthy of the promise of Christ.
Let us pray.
Grant, we beseech thee, O Lord God, that we, thy servants, may enjoy perpetual health of mind and body, and by the glorious intercession of the Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, be delivered from the present sorrow and enjoy eternal happiness, through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Friends, on behalf of the missionaries of prayer, we thank John, Asha, and their wonderful children, Sarah, Tracy, Kathy, and little Joseph, who led today's rosary so prayerfully. We thank God for the blessing they are to each other and to the rest of us. And we pray that God grants them the grace to be a blessing for so many others around the world. Today is little Joseph's birthday, and we pray that the Lord blesses him to be filled with joy and the grace to grow into a holy child and a blessing for others. We especially offer this intention, and along with that, we pray that they continue to seek God's kingdom in their lives. I would like to now invite Father Benedict to offer his priestly blessing. Let's bow our heads and receive this blessing.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Lord Jesus Christ, Make us not to worry about what we are to eat, drink, and wear. Always remind us that all these things we need will be given unto us if we seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
So thank you.
Thank you, Father. Thank you very much. God bless, Father.